Good afternoon, everyone present in the. Sir, your voice is not audible.
Ruchika.
My voice is audible. Can you hear?
No? Yes, Ruchika, you are audible. I request other participants.
Okay, thank you so much.
Yes, Ruchika, please go ahead.
Thank you, sir. So good afternoon, everyone present in the meeting. Good afternoon, all the jury members. Now, my topic for the presentation is BYOD. I remember that when I was in school, there was some few basics rules. First was to have a proper dress code. Second was the nail cut. And third and most punishable was to bring our own devices. But now the same thing has emerged as a culture, not only in school, but also in all educational as well as organizational purposes. And we call it BYOD, that is bring your own devices. So let's know a few things about what is BYOD. Just give me a moment, please. So BYOD, also called as BYOT, that is bring your own technology, or BYOP, that is bring your own phone, or it is also called as BYOPC, that is bring your own personal computer. Basically, it refers to being allowed to use one's personally owned devices rather than being required to use an officially provided device. Now, if we see the history, the term was initially used by Wise over Internet Protocol Service provided in 2004 with a service allowing businesses to bring their own devices for a more open service provider model. The phrase bring your own devices and the BYOD acronym is take off on the BYOB, a party invitation term first recorded in 1970, standing for bring your own beer, booze, or bottle. The term BYOD then entered common use in 2009 with the courtesy of Intel when it recognized an increasing tendency among its employees to bring their own smartphones, tablets, laptops, computer to work and connect with them in their corporate network. However, it took until early 2011 before the term achieved prominence when IT services provider and software vendor started to share their perception of this emergent trend. In 2012, US Equal Employment Opportunity Commission adopted a BYOD policy, but many employees continue to use their government-issued devices due to some concerns about the billing and lack of alternative devices. The proliferation of devices such as tablets, smartphone now used by many people in their daily lives and had led to a number of companies such as IBM to allow employees to bring their own devices to work due to perceived productivity gain and cost saving. The idea was initially rejected because of the security concern, but more and more companies are now looking to incorporate BYOD policies. According to a study in 2018, only 17% of enterprises provide mobile phones to all employees, 31% provided to none, and instead they are entirely based on the BYOD policy. And remaining 52% have some kind of hybrid approach, where some employees receive the corporate mobile phones and other expected to bring their own. So everything have two points. Some positive and some negative. In this, the same thing applies. So if we see the positive thing, there are also a study that employs that 82% of companies let employees to use personal devices for work. 90% of US employees use their own smartphone at work, and 70% of employees use companies issued tablets to download personal apps. With this, if we see the positive facts, there are increase in productivity, which means when the employee are using devices which is very much familiar to them, they can work freely, a very flexible environment, and employee can easily organize reports and answer business emails whenever it is required. Meantime, the employee can stay connected with their personal life through social media and personal use application. This can definitely make them stress-free, flexible, updated, and moreover, it it will increase the overall productivity of the business or organizational purposes. The second is the cost saving. Definitely, if the BYOD is implemented, then it can reduce overall company costs. If the employees are being their own devices, then it will reduce your maintenance cost, device cost, and hardware cost. And the company can save a lot of money when majority of cost is being paid by the employees itself. The next one is to improve employee loyalty. It is clear that BYOD strategy can increase employee loyalty to your business by allowing them to control their own work. Your employee can be empowered and they can also work offsite when they don't have to choose in between their personal and official devices. The next one is the lesser security risk. Of course, if you have a well-planned and executed BYOD policy for your organization, the all important business data will be stored up in cloud and all the connected personal devices will act as a terminals to access assigned file or folders. The next is work from anywhere, anytime. So as the BYOD promote personal devices use, it encourages employee to do all the pending tasks or important tasks after office hours also. It also improves the corporate communication and reporting. A quick email replies, access presentation, file transfer, document view, etc. It can also be done at anywhere, done at any time and from anywhere. It is clear that BYOD structure can greatly enhance employee productivity, connectivity, and engagement. Now that every coin has two sides, so the BYOD also has another side where an organization will have to face some challenges. Now the study also shows that 40% of large data breaches were caused by loss of stolen devices. 50% of companies that allowed BYOD were breached via employee-owned devices. And 60% of companies do not remove business data from their ex-employees' devices, which also lead to the data breaches. Now, if we see the risk, there are most significantly stolen devices. Out of 70 million devices, stolen devices, there are only 7% are recovered. And it has been also shown that 15% of employees have accessed the sensitive data from non-work sections devices. 54% of organizations don't include the employee-owned devices in their backup plans. 65% of companies cannot wipe devices remotely. And 76% of companies do not encrypt mobile devices. So if we talk about the challenges, there are a few challenges such as security control, employee privacy, the risk of hacking, and corporate IT policies. So there are a few basic steps. If we include these steps, we can also implement the BYOD policy successfully. First one is to establish security policies then create an acceptable use guide, install the mobile management software to configure management and monitor all the personal devices from one application, use two-factor authentication for company applications to keep your classified information secure by forcing anyone who log into an application to go through an extra step, such as providing answer to a security question or using a code that has been provided in an email or text message. Then you can also protect the company and personal data on employee devices. And simplify the sign-up process can also help in this process. Now, there are a few basic steps to establishing a successful BYOD policies. First one is to specify the devices that will be permitted. Establish a strict security policy for all the devices that enter in premises. Define a clear service policy for devices under BYOD criteria. There should be a clear communication needs to be given on who owns what app and data. There should also be what app will be allowed and what should be banned. We will also have to integrate the BYOD plan with acceptable use policy. And there is, of course, there will be a setting up with an employee exit strategy also. At the end, I would like to say that BYOD is an emerging and more usable policy. And it's like, we can also say that it's like a piece of drug, which means when we use it with accurate amount and with accurate security, it will act as a medicine to improve the motivation and productivity. And when we use it with carelessness and without proper restriction, it will act as a poison to privacy and security of the organization. So it's completely on us how we take it further. With this, thank you all the jury members and all the participants for patiently listening to me. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, sir.